Namaste, welcome to home hashtag life. I hope you all had a really happy and memorable Diwali. In today's video, I'm going to share with you how I have decorated one wall in my daughter's room, and at last, I will give you a quick 360 degree tour of that room. Also, it was her 7th birthday surprise as well. So I started this project, which she absolutely loved and adored so much. All my hard work and effort really paid off. Come, let me take you through the makeover step by step. We wanted pleasing colors on the wall. Reason? Such a wall can handle more decor and color on it, and the overall final look will be really nice. So here I have gone with a subtle combination of two colors. Also, I have opted for this gradient color for a reason. If you notice, the wardrobe and the headboard edges or heights are not really coordinated. So the gradient wall color will give a nice visual appeal and a sense of cohesiveness to the room. Bookshelves, beside being functional, play a super important role in the early development of kids and act as wall decor as well. I already have one shelf from IKEA, bought another one to create a wall library, and I have spray painted these wall bookshelves in white to pop nicely on the grey wall. The more the books are in your reach, the more you tend to pick them up. Every child needs two main strengths in the early growing years: language skills and number skills. School learning alone is not sufficient enough to strengthen these two skills. And that is why, to enhance her language skills, I have invested time and energy in making books available, accessible to her. And when we are talking about math skills and number skills, I have enrolled her in QMath since April, when the lockdown just began. It has been 7 months and she is doing her regular classes a week. For those who are not aware, QMath is an online math and coding learning platform for children from KG to 8th. It helps children to pick up math skills guided by expert teachers. Concepts are taught not by memorizing but through logical reasoning. Children develop their own mental models and reasoning skills when they go about solving math problems. Every day, she does math gyms in the app where she needs to solve problems within 10 minutes. She is in grade 2 and we love how the curriculum has been designed. It consists of different reasoning skills. In the class, doubts are immediately cleared by teachers. She is really fortunate to have a lovely teacher who understands her problem area as well and invests time, attention and energy to make concepts clear. I will be sharing a link for your reference in the description box where you can register for a free demo class. After attending the demo class, you will get to know how it works, and then you can enroll your children for regular classes. By using this link, you can avail of a 10% discount as well. As I mentioned in the intro, her birthday was coming up and we really wanted to give her a sweet surprise with some thoughtful messages. Pihu spends most of her time here in this room, so I thought, why not give her a few friends to keep her company. So I went about creating this wall art with this cute, adorable characters. I found this picture on Pinterest. I will share the link in the description box, so if you wish, you can check. And couldn't resist doing a mural on her bedroom wall. A mural is any piece of artwork painted or applied directly on a wall, ceiling, or other permanent surfaces. First, I drew all the figures with a pencil directly on the wall.
is made of home.
And then started painting them with acrylic colors.
We can together, all included, build a better life. This bridge is made of hope.
From my experience, I can suggest if you are going with big figures, then it's better to use chalk paints or emulsion paints than acrylic paints. Also, please note, if you are painting it on glossy wall surfaces, please check if the paint will stick on the surfaces well or not. For the outline, I have used permanent markers. While we are outlining, our hand has to be steady. Be patient. That is the key to a good finish, and these thin lines will make a world of difference in terms of finishing and change the entire look. It took me 2 days to complete this entire wall mural. It was really painstaking, but it was truly worth it. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up and leave a comment if you like this mural painting. Your comment, your love really matters.
There's a message drifting in.
On this wall, I am placing a few lightweight and simple frames. I always wanted to display some motivational quotes in her room. I have painted these wooden letters and pasted with Fevicol on the top of the frame. Simple yet lovely frames are ready to be hung, and I wish she always remembers these quotes as she grows up. And here there are 2 photo frames with endearing pictures to brighten up the space with our personal touches. I always like to add mirrors to lift up any small space. I'm placing this simple mirror with a minimal look here to add a touch of warmth to the room. This mirror is from IKEA, and so happy that it fits and matches perfectly here in this space. Adding some fairy lights along the edges of this mirror. By the way, are you a big fan of fairy lights and love to keep them even if it's not really a festival time? Do let me know why so, because I love them too. She is a dreamer who loves to dream, and why not give her a cloud to wander on? While I was designing her room, this was the thought came into my mind. Clouds are there on her wardrobe's handles, on the door, on the bed, and luckily I got these cloud stickers from IKEA which I'm fixing here. It gives a sweet, childish, innocent vibe to the room. And how can I forget this cloud lamp? All in all, isn't this wall makeover cute? What do you think? Please let me know. Days will pass, years will pass, and my little daughter will grow up soon. Let's cherish the days we have with them now and create simple, thoughtful spaces for them. Be sure to give this video a big thumbs up if you have enjoyed watching this wall makeover, and don't forget to tag me on Instagram if you are going to attempt it. I share a lot of behind the scenes videos, pictures and life updates. So if you wish, you can find us on Instagram and Facebook. The handle is same, home hashtag life by Jaya. And please do subscribe to our YouTube channel. And I will see you in the next one. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.